Welcome to all of you. We'll see today the illustration of mathematical formulation, how we go about mathematical formulation. Check the problem number one, look at the problem and carefully analyze it. A vessel contains mixture of milk and water in a ratio 5:3. We'll try to build a table. We'll have stage. We'll have milk. We have water. We have mixture. And we have ratio of milk to water. Initial stage, we are given that milk and water are in the ratio 5:3. So we can assume that, say 5A will be what milk, 3A will be water, and total will be 8A. So I can say that this ratio I can write down as 5/8 to 3/8. 5/8 to 3/8. I can write down the ratio like this. Okay. Now, 7 liter of mixture is taken out. After I take out the 7 liter of mixture, what will happen? I'll get whatever left out mixture I'm having. So let's say it's having C liters of milk, having D liters of water, and therefore the mixture will become 8A minus 7. We know 8A was initial, 7 liters taken out, so 8A minus 7. And milk to water ratio will be C:D. Perfect. Now 7 liter of water is added. When 7 liter of water is added, nothing is added to C. Water is added with 7 liter. And 7 liter added here, it will become once again 8A. 7 liter taken out, 7 liter added. So once again 8A. But the proportion here will become C:D+7. Now what is given? This resultant ratio is given as 5:7. Now we'll try to solve the problem from this particular component. Let's see how we go about. C upon D plus 7 is equal to 5/7. And therefore cross multiply, 7C is equal to 5D+7. 5:7, is it all right? C:D+7 is 5:7. So we are correct. So 7C will be equal to 5 into this. And therefore, now further what we'll get? This ratio is available. Now we'll try to find the value of C in terms of D or D in terms of C. How many liters of milk were there in the can? We find initially whatever is there, let's try to find the value of C. What will be value of C? I'll put it. From C, 7 liter is taken out from the entire mixture. So that 7 liter will have some component of milk, some component of water. What is component of milk? 5/8 component milk. So therefore from this, 5/8 of 7 liter is taken out. So this is the value of C which is left out. So C will be what? Initial C was 5A. And from that 5/8 of 7 liter is taken out. And this will become my C. My C will be whatever milk was there, from which when 7 liter of mixture taken out, 5/8 of the 7 liter will be milk. So it is reduced and my C is this. And therefore I will get C is equal to 40A minus 35 upon 8. Now should I write C over here? C is equal to 40A minus 35 upon 8. Just for calculations, I am analyzing and putting it over here. Similarly, I will calculate for D. D is equal to what? 3A minus 7 liter of mixture is taken out. From that 7 liter, 3/8 was my water. So 3/8 of 7 taken out. So cross multiply, we'll get here 8 into 3, this is 8. 8 into 3, 24A minus 7 into 3, 21. Okay, so my D will be equal to 24A minus 21 upon 8. Alright, I know C, I know D. Okay, and now I will come down to this equation. In this equation, I will once again write down in a bigger way 7C is equal to 5 into D plus 7. D plus 7. 7C is equal to 5 into D plus 7. Why I have created curly brackets? I know the value of C. The value of C is 40A minus 35 upon 8. Value of D is 24A minus 21 upon 8. Now if you simplify this, multiply the entire equation. Multiply the entire equation by 8. What I get? 7 into 40A minus 35 is equal to 5 into 24A minus 21 and plus this 8 into what I'll get? 8 into the 5 is outside, okay? 8 into this 56. Am I right? Yes. Alright, so this is what I get. Now I will rub the table and try to simplify. Single equation, single unknown. So my aim is to get the value of A. Okay. Let us see how we solve it. When you multiply this, 7 into 40, 280. 7 into 35, 245 minus 5 into 24, sorry, this will be equal to 5 into 24A, 120A minus 21 into 5, 105 plus 56 into 5, so this will be 33 and 28. So I get simplified equation like this. Now reshuffle. 280A minus 120A is equal to 245 will go on that side minus 105 plus 280. Now this will be 160A. 245 minus 105 is 140 plus 280, 420. So A will be 420 by 160 is equal to 42 by 16 is equal to 21 by 8. Just check A is equal to 21 by 8 will suffice the purpose or not. Now what is the question? How many liters of milk was there initially? Initially how many liters of milk was there? We know initially 8A total mixture, out of that 5A was milk. So 5 times 21 by 8, this will be the milk. So milk will be 31.125 liters of milk was there to begin with. So thus we critically analyze the problem, nicely mathematically formulate it. Solution is a monotonous one like previous one. Now let's see the next problem. Read the problem, carefully analyze it so that we can solve it. First of all, you have to formulate it. Let's see, 10 women can complete a work in 9 days. Let's consider the work which is done by a woman in a day. Let it be a work done by a lady in a day, say L. And therefore, we know that 10 such ladies, what will be their rate of doing the work? Let the total work is equal to W. Then 10 ladies together can finish W in 9 days. Okay. So what is the rate of doing work by a single lady? Ten children do the same work in 15 days. So what is the rate at which one child can work? Divided by 10. Now it is given that how many days will 5 women and 10 children will take to complete the work. So 5 ladies and 10 children, they will finish the work. We do not know in how many days. Let's consider that they finish the work in D days. And our aim is to find the value of D. Now, 5, L, 10, C, W by D. 5 L, L is what? W by 90. C is what? W by 150. And you realize, initially we thought there are two unknowns and one equation, how we can solve it? But W gets cancelled at the top and we get a simple equation, 5 by 90 plus 10 by 150 is equal to 1 by D. For 90 and 150, I'll get LCM as 450. 5 by 90 is, I divide 450 by 90, I'll get 5. So it is nothing but 25 by 450. Plus 150, I divide 450 by that, I'll get 3. 3 into this, 30. Is equal to 55 by 450. 11 by 90. So 1 by D is 11 by 90. And therefore, I'll get D is equal to 90 by 11. Is equal to 8.18 days. Thus, once we formulate the problem, solution becomes very easy. Let's see a different type of problem. Read the problem carefully and then we will try to see the solution part. You have seen the solution part also? Earlier question solution have you seen? Just go back. So this was problem number one. Next, this is solution. You nicely read the solution carefully. Then go to the next problem. This is the problem. Go to the solution. Now solution is illustrated in front of you. We move to the problem number three. Next. Okay. A person when asked about his age during the census survey, let's see the solution. Yes. Look here. What was the age of the person? Let's say the age of the person be P. A person when asked about his age during census survey, his reply was, take my age 2 years hence. So current age is P. So 2 years hence the age will be P plus 2. Multiply it by 5. So multiply it by 5. Then subtract 5 times. My age 15 years ago. P's age 2 years hence, multiply by 5, minus 5 times P's age 15 years ago. And then you say that you will know how old I am. So that is equal to P. So single equation, single unknown, plainly solve it. 2P plus 10 minus, sorry, 5P minus 10 minus 5P plus 75 is equal to P. And this P, 5P value will cut down, 10 plus 75, 85. So P's current age is 85. And what is this statement? 2 years hence, this 85 plus 2 will become 87 minus 5. 85 plus 15 will become 70. Is equal to 85 or not? We'll check. 85 plus 2, 87. So 5 into 87 minus 5 into 70 is equal to 85 or not? Check it. 5 common, 87 minus 70. 5 common, this is 70. Verified. So we have obtained the answer very quickly and verified also. Next, see the solution part of it. Yes, go through the solution. Same thing which we obtained. Let us see the next problem. Yes, check the problem. The difference between a two-digit number and the number obtained by interchanging the digit is 18. Let's see how it goes about. The difference between this and this number and number obtained by interchanging this is 18. This number is what? 10a plus b. This number is what? 10b plus a is equal to 18. Now simplify it. 10a plus b minus 10b minus a is equal to 18. 10a minus a, 9a. B minus 10b minus 9b is equal to 18. So divide by 9a minus b is equal to 2. So I got this as equation 1. Further, it is given that the ratio between the digits of the number is 3 by 2. So it is given that a by b is equal to 3 by 2. And therefore, a is equal to 3 by 2b. This is equation 2. Solve these two equations simultaneously. We'll put the value of a in this. And what I get? A minus b is equal to a minus b is equal to 2. Now, here I am putting the value of a. A is what? 3 by 2b. So, 3 by 2b minus b is equal to this. And therefore, 1 by 2b is 2. And therefore, b is equal to 4. B is equal to 4. A is equal to 3 by 2b. Is equal to 3 by 2 into 4? 6. So, my a is 6. And b is 4. So, my original number is 64. Minus interchange number is 46. And check whether it is coming 18 or not. Yes. Check it. Whether it is coming 18 or not. Yes, it is coming. And then further, a by b is equal to 64 means 6 by 4. And it is coming 3 by 2. So, this is also checked. So, we are able to get the answer. Thus, we formulate the problem and try to solve the simultaneous equation. Let's go to the next example. The last example of today's illustration. A tin of oil was 2/3 full when 4 bottles of oil were taken out and 2 bottles of oil were poured into it. It was half full. Let's see. Let's see how we go about. Carefully. Now, I can put the volume of the tin T in terms of liters, or I can put in terms of number of bottles. Full tin is equal to let B bottles of oil. Full tin contains B bottles of oil. Okay. A tin of oil was 2/3 full. So, it is containing 2/3 bottles of oil to begin with. 4 bottles of oil were taken out, minus 4. 2 bottles of oil were poured into it, plus 2. It was half full. So, it equal to half of total B. Total B bottle is the capacity. So, half B. So, we get one equation, one unknown, and we have to find out the value of B. 3 and 2 are the denominators. I want to get irradiated with denominators. In order to remove fraction, I multiply the entire equation by 6. And I get multiplied by 6, 4b. Multiplied by 6, 24. Multiplied by 6, 12. Multiplied by 6, 3b. And therefore, 4b minus 12 is equal to 3b. So, 4b minus 3b is equal to 12. So, b is equal to 12. And that means the capacity of the tank is 12 bottles. 12 bottles is the full capacity of the tank. And 2/3 of b will be 2/3 of 12 minus 4 plus 2 is equal to half of 12. Just check it. 2/3 of 12 is 8. 8 minus 4 plus 2. 8 minus 4, 4. 4 plus 2, 6. And half of 12 is 6. So verify it. Thus we are able to get the answer. Look here. There is no limit for the mathematical formulation. Mathematical formulation of the problem can It can be any type of problem, but we have to formulate it very carefully. As in the concept part of it illustrated, different types of problem could be there. But then the way in which we handle them, whatever is asked in the problem, we do not know, assume it as a variable. Whatever relationship are given in the problem, in terms of variable, put it. And then put the equations, solve them simultaneously, get the answer. Substitute one answer into the other equation, get the other answer. Thus, we solve the problem. Now, friends, the intelligence is required in formulating the problem, but solution requires high school mathematics. However, time required for puzzle is required for maturity, required for calculation.
If you master the calculation in the preparation time, what will happen? Your speed of calculation will increase and the maturity gradually increases with the exposure and difficultness of the problem. More the problem you solve, the exposure will enrich you and it will give a spark or an intelligence to you that whenever problem comes in, it will click in your mind. Yes, this is closest to this type of problem in mathematics. You will formulate it and solve it. All the best to all of you. Thank you.